Good morning, students. In today's video, I am going to share with you an amazing chess opening tricks by which you can gain a significant advantage in the first few moves. This secret trick is also called fried liver attack. So watch till end. Okay, let's start the opening. You play pawn to e4, e5. Knight to f3 and knight to c6, then bishop to c4. This is a very popular opening, and I'm sure you must have seen this opening position many times in your games. Today's trick revolves around this opening. It's black turns now, and this move is very crucial and very common. This move and you are ready to go. That's exactly what you wanted. Here we are, start trying to your trap, and now you have to play knight g5. By playing this move, you are attacking black's weakest pawn on f7 and also threatening to gain significant amount of material. So black has to somehow give additional pressure, additional support on this pawn, or block the bishop from attacking. Since supporting the pawn is just not possible, so black has to block this bishop by playing d5. Now you should take the pawn by playing e capture d5. Now there are few variations from here. I'll try to cover the all main line, so you have to an idea how to win from different position. I'm not covering each and every move because it's practically not possible. What I'm going to show you is all the best possible move that you can expect from black. Okay, so basically there are two good moves that you will see from here. First, knight captures d5. Then it's time to surprise your opponent. So you will play beautiful sacrifice on knight capture f7. As you can see, now black has to left with no option. You will have to capture on his next move. Okay, black has now also lost his right to castling. It's your turn. So you can play queen f3, check. Black can't move his knight because it's pinned by the bishop. If black trying to bring his queen between, then you can easily capture his knight by your bishop. So basically black has to move his king. If he move g8, then queen bishop captures knight, check. Queen capture bishop, queen capture bishop. After bishop e6, queen captures e6, it's a checkmate. Going back, if he move king to e7, e8 or g6, then you easily capture the knight with your bishop. So those are not a good move for black. Okay, the best move for black probably to be move his king on e6, then knight c3. It put additional pressure on d5 knight. From here on, black basically has two good moves to support this d5 knight. First, knight to b4. forking our king and rook. Our next move should be play a3. Yes, a3. Because our aim in this position to open the board. Because black king is in the center. Our rook is not that important because it's not active. So it's a very good move considering the situation of this game. Okay, black obvious pawn the capture the pawn on c2. And after king d1, knight captures the rook. Okay, as you can see, you can capture his knight on d5. Now black king is very danger. We are threatening to give double check on knight capture c7. And after king move, we will capture the rook on a8. So king to d6 is a good move. And your next move is d4. Sacrifice the pawn but open the diagonal for the dark square bishop. If black capture the pawn, then bishop f4 check. This should a very bad position for black. You can get a lot of attacking option from here, and it's completely winning for white. Okay students, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any queries and any doubt, please put it on the comment box. Thanks for the day. Bye students.